Got it all mounted up. I'll just spin the engine stand around with that. I thought we'd do that. Slip this thing right up underneath there. Oh, you know something? Put something on there I probably shouldn't have. Hold on. There's a engine mount left on. That was a mistake. This one real quick. Need that. Now we gotta slip the engine. I'm not sure what the best way to go about doing this is, to tell you the truth. Can I just go that way, get up high enough, and then roll one leg of the engine stand underneath the thing, maybe? Sideways like this. Let's see if I can fit. I think there's a witness mark somewhere. I think I see something. Whoa, we can have a fast one for you too. We're all right. Let me see. Yeah. Everything looks securely mounted up. I think they're just right. And you got it.
Slide off.
Yeah, what we're gonna end up doing now is put that other engine, back on the engine stand, the right engine stand, so I can move it around. So this guy's mounted, all I gotta do is remount all that hardware, which I say is just, really not that easy, but the hard part's done. Getting the motor on the stand is key. I'll start mounting up the, might as well do a little bit more.
So you're not still on camera?
Yeah. Let me bring you in a little closer. So what we're going to do now, start mounting up some of this stuff, kind of tidying up the situation a little bit. Start with that alternator. I think you'll see it there. It's just hanging here, and it's because it's just hanging, it's kind of not in a, you know, super safe situation, so. The sooner I start getting this stuff putting back together, the better. I never really designed this engine stand to be taken apart so easily, you know? So I didn't make provisions for unbolting things. So, but you know, it worked out all right. Right now, I'm just trying to get a couple bolts started on this alternator. Tighten up everything after I get set in position. My dad, who worked in the Navy as an aircraft mechanic, said, "Don't ever tighten up all the bolts, son, until you get everything fitted." All right, Dad. That's what I'm doing. I'm gonna get everything started before anything gets tightened up. Bolt is fighting me, so I'm gonna stop fighting it a little bit. Again, just really kind of about getting stuff kind of situated so it's a little less precarious. Right now everything's kind of in limbo. I think it's tight. That bolt is tight, tight, tight. Wrenches on things. But I'm trying. Just want to not have to spend too much time finding tools right now. And I thought I had all these things in finger tight, so I'm surprised I didn't have to fight this at all. Adjusting bracket a hair. There we go. Now we can just make it easy. Now it fits. Now we can adjust it. There you go. Okay. That was secure. I'll come back and adjust all that stuff later. Next thing I want to get secured up is the motor mount. The starter mount, I should say. Let's see if I can get that over here. See how that looks. That's going to be in the frame. I'm going to close that garage down so you don't get so much backlight. Oh, no, I'm not. Okay. Well, I'm not going to move. So this has to come off. Again, I typically wouldn't be using adjustable wrench, but ready to go
find everything. So we take this, the engine stand mount off, and I can bolt on the starting plate. And the starting plate is just a good way to mount the starter without having to have a transmission bolted on. The plate itself is stout enough to hold the starter in position against the ring gear on the flywheel. So that's what we're going to do right here. This thing out. That engine that's sitting on the tire, and then I can, put it back away. I gotta drain all the coolant. I gotta take the block plug out. It still has, like, when I drained it, I got about a gallon and a quart out, so that means it's probably 3/4 of a gallon still in the engine. So I've got a bit of a mess. Those bolts are kind of hard to find. You know, like grade 10 bolts or something like that. All right. Get that down here for now. Actually, I think it's what I said. That's what I'm going to do. All right. So, like I said, what I'm going to do now, let's take a look at the. Just looking at the rear main seal. Okay, so this thing here is a starter. And it bolts to pinion. Bolts on. Wait. I think that's right. Yeah. This, then the flywheel. It's like it's stupid here. Hold on a minute. Duh. This, then the flywheel. Uh oh. Need to put two of these bolts on. This goes. It stays like this. Should be a locating dowel right there. Dowel. Locating dowel. Oh, damn, I got these bolts here. Oh, darn it. I need all those washers. There's something about the depth of the washer, the screw, the bolt I'm using, and the hole. So, I recall this needed 3 washers on this particular one. All right. Got another dowel here? I guess not. There's 2 dowels. Come on. There you go. Getting started. And I think the other one was on the other side over here.
Another one I have there. A whole bunch of washers on. Pardon why I get in the way. Pardon you why you get in my way. Alright. I'll tell you about, let's try another one. This bike needs a lot. Alright. Let's put one of these guys down in there. This guy's supposed to be back, I think. Yeah. This one's supposed to have it. Now on the transmission. Big fat pit, dowel goes in there, it goes around that bolt. Whew. Getting the idea here is I just want to get this thing kind of secure. I got so much stuff hanging all over the place that it's kind of dangerous. Can get his top in now. Now I'll bolt on that flywheel in a little bit. First thing, I gotta get this situated. Okay. It's
some big heavy stuff attached. Putting a lot on these things. I mean, I only use this to test run an engine, so it's not like it's got to be worked to spec or anything. Okay, so that's secure. I put the flywheel on next. Dare I do that? Whew, that could be some good comic relief. At least if I can get that flywheel on. I'll move you over here so you get a little bit better action on the flywheel install. All right, hope that's really good. Let's see if that looks on camera. Oh yeah. It's about 90 degrees outside right now. Probably feels like about 100 degrees because of the inside the garage, no breeze, and in the high humidity of Florida. All right, this is gonna be fun because this thing's really heavy. I'm trying to remember which way it was on. Obviously, the pressure plate goes on the outside. I get one of these bolts started, kind of located. It's got a little bit of a locating ring, the tiniest little bit. Not much. It might be a little low here, so I'm doing. All right, got one right at top dead center. Okay, good to go. Safe. I won't use the adjustable wrench on this. I'll tighten this up later with a proper wrench. Spin that over. Spin the engine over a little bit. Just kind of reposition the weight of that flywheel. Okay, this one will go in. Okay. That one's fighting, so what I'm going to do. Switch the bolts around, make sure it's not the buggered up bolt or something. That one's going in just fine, so just swap these two around. I think it's just the bolt hole's a little hot. Put a little bit of torque on it, see what happens. That's probably it was like a 17, maybe a 19. probably 17. If it starts fighting me at all, I'll just stop. Get a thread chaser on it. Ah, shucks.